So as soon as you have added this component, you can see all the 16 elements are basically looking like a grid.
Welcome to Vinix Studio. Let's start making games.
Hi and welcome to another Unity tutorial. Today we'll be seeing how to create a grid UI using a custom script provided by Unity, which is called Grid Layout Group. Now, Grid Layout Group can be attached to a game object, and all the game objects which are children of the Grid Layout Group will be arranged in a grid fashion. So let's go ahead and see how to do it. So we'll be creating some 16 UI elements and we'll try to arrange them in a group. So let's go to hierarchy window and click on the plus sign UI and click on image. So I'll call this as cell. Okay, so this will act as one cell and the width and height will be set to 100x100. So mostly in a UI there's a button, so I'll also add a child which is a button. So let's go to UI and button. Okay, and let's call this button as icon, and I don't need the text inside the button, so I'll be deleting that. And this button also should be in Y shape, so let's set it to 60x60. Okay, so now we have our grid cell, and we'll assign some image to the background. So I have downloaded this pre-planned GUI from Unity Asset Store. It's a free asset. The link is there in the description. You can download that. So let's go inside that and see if we have any sprites that we can give. Okay, I'll use the square. So I'll assign that to the sprite of the background. Okay. And then I need an icon. Select the button and then assign this icon. So that looks like a grid cell. So all we have to do is just make it into a prefab. So now let's just drag and drop this into the project folder. So now we have a cell prefab. Now we need 16, so just hold on control and press D 15 times. Okay, so now we have 15 of them. So these are our grid cells. Now let's go ahead and create an empty game object, empty UI game object, and we'll call this as grid, and we'll position it to 0, 0. You have to increase the height and width to basically enclose all the, so each grid cell is 100x100, so the grid can be somewhere between 400 and 500, so let's set to 450x450, and it will be in the center. Now let's select all the cells and make them as children of grid. Okay, so now the last step is just to add the grid layout component. So I'll click on the add component button, search for grid, and okay, it's called grid layout group. Just click on that. So as soon as you have added this component, you can see all the 16 elements are basically looking like a grid. The cell size should be equal to whatever the cell size you have created. So it was 100x100. And spacing between the cells, we can have some spacing like 2. Then the start corner is upper left, which is fine, starting from here. And then the start axis should be set to horizontal if your game is in the landscape mode. And it should be set to vertical if your game is in portrait mode. So I'll leave it to horizontal as of now. And the alignment is based on where you want the child to be. I generally prefer central alignment, that way the padding is not required. So let's go and select middle center. So if you want a fixed number of rows or fixed number of columns, then you can just give the constraint. So if you're very sure that you need 4 number of columns, then you can just select this and enter 4 columns. So that way even when it is resized, it will make sure that there are 4 columns in that. So I'll leave it to flexible because I don't have any constraints for my UI. So with that done, now let's go to the canvas and set it as scale with screen size. Okay, so now if we scale this to something bigger, the UI also scales with it. Now, if you have more number of elements that you cannot fit in one screen, then you can also have a scrollable UI. You can check out the video on the top to see how to make the UI scrollable. So this was the basics of creating a grid UI in Unity. So if you have any other questions, you can leave them in the comment box below. Thank you and see you in the next tutorial.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.